Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me. If you wish to help support my channel, all you have to do is subscribe and share my videos. Or you can join my Patreon account for as little as $1 a month. Here we have a live view of the Upper Geyser Basin taken from the live Old Faithful webcam. Both the Southern Loop and the Northern Loop of Yellowstone is now open. Mammoth Vault isn't working that well. Looks like they just got the Norris Geyser station up and running. There was questions about Parker Peak. Yeah, there was a lot marked in red. Let me show you this. They're still doing road work. So more than likely, this has been created because of the road work that's going on. And the reason I say that also is the fact that none of the other monitors show any of the similar, what would some people assume as earthquakes on any of them. It's been very quiet for earthquakes there at Yellowstone ever since they had the flooding. Did the flooding cool off the volcano? Yeah, anything's possible. They know so little about volcanoes, but yeah, the activity has, yeah, been next to none, but there has been a few little ones. I downloaded Lake Butte, which is there on the east side of Yellowstone Lake, Moose Creek, Idaho. That would often show earthquakes that show up there for Sawtooth along the Snake River Plateau and maybe Stanley. And this is the borehole 207 for the Madison River area. And I thought I would show you here. Yeah, it's been quiet. Really quiet. We, you know, we got a few marked in red, like right here where I singled this one out at 1237. And let's go to the seismic signature. I wonder if I can make it bigger for you. Let's see. There we go. This is Lake Butte, and this would be a very small earthquake, 1.68. And let's see, we got another one. Well, there's a little teeny tiny one right there at 1524. This is all universal time. The popping of the rock. We got harmonic tremors. This comes in as a magnitude 0.37. It is tiny. Let me make that bigger for you. Yeah, harmonic magma is trying to come up, and we know that they're at the lake. They got a crack at the bottom of the lake where the magma's been trying to come up. I don't know if you can see that, but that's all harmonic tremor. So also here at Lake Butte at 1653, it's probably two different earthquakes, but I put it all together. See that? Harmonic tremors. And this comes in as a magnitude 1.26. There's only been some real small stuff that's been going on, like I said. Let's see if we can make that bigger. Okay, yep, harmonic tremors. That means when magma's coming into this system, rising up, because magma naturally wants to rise, kind of like a beach ball held underneath a body of water that's filled with air. It just wants to rise up. Then we got another teeny tiny one there. More popping of the rock. Yeah, that would be very small. 0.33. Let's look at its seismic signature. Yeah, and then we got another teeny tiny one right there. That comes in as a 0.50. You know, they're having individual small quakes different places. And they're not reporting them. They probably should, but maybe they're concentrating on repairing the roads there at the park. The monitor for Moose Creek, Idaho. Yeah, you can see we got several marked in red here. Yeah, magma was coming into the system, and you know it comes up from down in that area. There we go. And let's look at the seismic signature. Yeah, let's make that bigger. Rounded tops. Yeah, magma on the move. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files just a little while ago. Now this one looks like we have a mix of tectonic and harmonic tremors. And then there's a small one here, but it's not marked in red. That looks like a tremor. Slow moving earthquake. No definite, beginning, you can say right there, but it lasted for quite a while. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, we'll go to another monitor. Yeah, slow moving tremors all through here. Look at that. And with mixture of tectonic. See how it's round with the sharp points? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, this is tectonic movement. Yeah, slow moving tremors. And we got a little tiny one down here. And let's see if I can make it bigger for you. And then we got another one up over here on the right. Let's see. Yeah, tectonic. See that? Sharp points. 929. But they're not getting that many small earthquakes for some reason, which is completely out of character. They're at Yellowstone. Completely out of character. So I thought I would check the tilt meters, what's going on. Well, this is the borehole for Yellowstone Lake, and there is no data available whatsoever. Yeah, it hasn't been anything for a month. And then this goes back all the way back to 2008. And it's showing, going up over here, because we know that the lake is tipping. Yeah. Yeah, and there was quite a few... a whole year where they weren't collecting data. And this is where they reset the tilt machine. The tilt meter for Grant went offline right after the 3rd. Now, Grant was an area that was showing a lot of earthquakes. It's an area where the ground is probably more brittle, and it was having a lot of earthquakes. But I don't know why it went offline. So that was for the last week. And then this would be for the last month. Yeah, you can see all the dots here. Where it was, going up and down, up and down. And that's a lot of movement for a month. Okay, and let's go down here. Going back to 2009. And, see it rose, went off the chart. They went out and reset the machine. That was when... Back in 2018, where they started having all that heat coming up, mostly from the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Yeah, so it went off the paper, as I called it back then, and then they reset the machine. But I don't like the fact that we don't have current data for uplift, which would be the tilt machine. Borehole 950, once again, no data, going back the last week. And you can see we got uplift going back since 2014. It's been rising. This is in radians. Yeah, teeny tiny uplift. Another monitor, a borehole for Norris Geyser Basin, borehole 205. Again, no data. This is supposed to be for 30 days. This is supposed to be for a week. Absolutely nothing. And here you can see in 2019, they reset the machine. Yep. And they reset it in 2014. Yeah. Yeah, I don't like, we don't have the data for the uplift. This is really important stuff to have. When you want to keep an eye on a super volcano, you should have data. Oh, probably a good month ago, they all got together there at Mammoth Vault, the northern part of the lake before the rains and the flooding happened. And during that time of the meeting, they had an earthquake swarm going on. That was rather convenient, I think, for the volcano to send a message, God to send a message saying, oh, look, it went down. Saying, hey, wake up. quit BSing the people. Get your monitors up and running. Get your ducks in a row. Yeah, I don't know. Let's try and get this to go again. Yeah, it's not going to play. They received all kinds of extra income to fix the infrastructure for the flooding. I know they've been having network problems, and I guess a third or a fourth person got attacked by a buffalo there. Yeah, these people need to learn these are not pets, they're wild animals, and to stay away from the wildlife. So that's all I have for you right now. Yeah, it's very curious. The calm before the storm, we'll see. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please share. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.